everyone, Nicholas Stallings here. Today we're going to talk about switch-adapted Nerf guns. This was the final project that I did with Dixie Blackwell for the ATACP course at CSUN. I have to admit, I didn't think that I was going to be able to do this, but it turns out that it's actually pretty easy, pretty straightforward, with a little bit of practice, the right parts, and of course some patience. I think this is something anyone can do at home. None of these exist on the market. I've only seen one other video of a dad who did this for his son. So I think it's something that could be really cool, and I guess let's go ahead and get started. Alright, so first we're going to start with why we did this. I don't know if anyone's familiar with the switch-adapted toys that are available on the market, but first of all, there aren't very many, and the ones that do exist tend to be something like this. Alright, so as you can see, there's a pretty legitimate need for a switch-adapted Nerf gun. If you're older than 3 or 4 years old, Dottie the Dachshund or the Flippy Floppy Bunny isn't going to be very exciting. And of course, if you're a boy, Dora the Explorer isn't going to be something you want to play with anyways. So that's why we did this. Okay, so now let's talk about the gun itself. I decided to go with the Hyperfire Elite, which ended up being an okay decision. The okay being, it actually has two motors that run on this thing. The batteries are held back here, and you have two motors, one that feeds the darts into the motor that shoots it. At first, I was going to go the route of battery interrupter, which an example of is here. A battery interrupter basically works by being slipped in between the batteries and the actual gun or the toy itself, and it literally interrupts the flow of electricity from the battery to the toy. Well, this ended up being a problem because of this. This is what's called the booster or the launcher, and that's what really shoots the darts. When you just interrupt the battery, these set down so that way it automatically fires when you hit the switch. The motor in the front never gets going fast enough to really shoot the dart. And there was no way we were going to lose any kind of velocity or anything with this gun. I wanted it to work just the way it should. So I opted with a hard wire. And I'm going to take this gun apart and show you next what exactly I did and why. For the tools for this project, you're going to need a few things. First, you're going to need a Phillips screwdriver to get the toy apart. Next, you're going to need a soldering iron and some solder. You'll also need a 1/8 inch female audio jack. And this is a mono jack. You don't want to get one of the stereo jacks. You'll also need some wire, and really any wire will do as long as it can handle the 6 volts that the toy runs on, which is 4D batteries. You'll also need a sub-mini switch and some wire strippers. Once you remove the 20 screws that hold the gun together, this is what you're going to find. As you can see, yours is going to look a little bit different because I've already made the modifications. But you can see here the two motors. This is the motor that loads the darts from the clip, and this is the motor that actually shoots them. Now there's a couple of safety features in this thing, so that way the gun doesn't run unless everything is put together correctly. But to give you a quick idea, if I depress this, pretending like the clip is inserted, you can rev the launcher, and then once the launcher is revved, you can hit the trigger to feed the darts. I'm going to get a little bit closer here and show you exactly what you're going to need to do to bypass these problems, while also making sure that this gun could still be used without the switch. So now let's take a closer look at the inside and the first motor. This motor is going to be the one that feeds the darts from the clip into the actual launcher. We'll worry about the launcher later. First thing you'll need to do is wire up a female 1/8 inch jack plug. What this is going to do is allow you to plug a switch into it. You can see we have a switch here. This is just a standard jelly bean switch. But what you're doing here, a switch basically works by interrupting the circuit. When the circuit is complete, you get power and electricity running. When the circuit's interrupted, you need something to connect to complete the circuit, and that's what a switch does. So first thing you're going to do is take two red wires, as we have here, and you're going to solder those in line here. One of your lines is going to run directly to the power. This is the power coming out of the battery holder here. As you can see, I soldered in. I have two, because I have one running to the launcher and one to the feeder, which feeds the darts from the clip. The feeder is connected to the jelly bean switch. The launcher we're going to have to do something else with. The other line is going to run directly to your motor. And you can see there's two positive red wires coming out here. One was in existence when we got the gun, and this is what I installed. When the switch is depressed with those two wires connected here to this female plug, when the switch is depressed, you can, as you can see here, you get power to the motor. Now the best thing about this, and this is why we decided to go this route instead of using a battery interrupter, is that the gun, when you depress all the safety features, will still work without the switch. And that's what I wanted to keep. So some of the basic features, but also make it switch accessible. So next we're going to move on to the launcher and the actual motor that shoots the darts. If you remove this little piece here, which is also a safety feature on the gun, this will not fire. This gun will fire unless this is snapped into place. You can pull this off, and you're going to see four screws that you're going to have to remove. Two down here at these points, and two down here. After doing so, you'll be able to pull these two things off and flip the motor around to be able to see the back of it. If you look closely, you can see my handiwork. This red wire here was what was in existence when we bought the gun. This is how it's set up. But if you look here, you'll see a looped wire that connects two small points, one on here and one here, and then another, a third red wire that I installed that's going to run back to the main switch, and that's where our small toggle switch comes in. These two points keep the electricity flowing and while still hitting these two resistors. If you look closely, you can see two yellow resistors there. Basically what they're doing is amplifying the power to make the motors run faster. So what we did is we linked them in, and then we connected them to the switch, which can be found here. This switch is exactly like the first switch that we installed. You can see two points. I believe if we connect them, we'll get power. But we have one running to that motor in the front, and one running directly to the positive side of the battery pack. What this allows us to do is, by having this switch, if you remember when I stated earlier that the gun didn't have as much velocity as it did when we used the battery interrupter, what this is going to allow you to do is get that first motor running, the one that actually fires the darts, by turning this on. And as you can see, that's running. And with our second switch, we can engage this first motor, which will fire the darts. So we've gone ahead and reassembled all of the parts and pieces. And this is what the gun would look like, of course, cut in half, with the clip in and ready to fire. I've unloaded all the darts, so we shouldn't have any emergency or crazy shots going off here. But this will give us an idea of how everything works without the switches. So when the clip is in and you have all your safety features, you have this white piece down, you have the clip button depressed, what you can do is test how the normal workings would be. So this would give us our booster, and this gives us our launcher. And this is shooting the darts into the launcher, which shoots the darts. So we know that all works correctly. Now we can check our wiring to make sure that everything that we did is going to work correctly. So first, we know that this won't fire without bullets getting fed from the clip. So as you can see, this seems to be working. This is one thing, and I don't know if you noticed how it kind of was laggy when I first depressed it. I'm not sure what's making the lagginess in that motor. But once it gets going, you can see it's a lot more responsive. So that's something that someone could maybe tell me about.
But also we know that even if the feeder is going, if we don't have the main or the front motor running, it's not going to shoot anything. So this is where our toggle switch comes in. And we can test that. It looks like we're getting up to full power with that, which is great. And although we have a little bit of a lag at first, it looks like the two motors are working together with the switches correctly. Okay, so we've got the gun reassembled, and we've also got it built on this nice little CPVC frame. I did this because the gun doesn't actually stand up on its own, and if a child wants to use it, who uses a wheelchair, I haven't quite figured out a wheelchair mount yet either. So this was my next best idea. At least it can sit up somewhere and can be still be fired from a wheelchair with relative ease. So let's go ahead and make sure everything runs right. Looks like we've got some movement coming from our feeder. And we'll flip on our switch here. You can see I just drilled a little hole to get this toggle switch through. Looks like everything's running well, so we'll go ahead and enter the clip. And it looks like it works. Right on. So a few closing notes here. As you can see, and like I talked about earlier, this switch is definitely not accessible. If I was to do this again, I would find a gun that only has one motor, not two, with the feeder and the launcher motor. Another deal, we definitely need to get this wheelchair accessible, mounted to a wheelchair. I'm thinking this is a good idea, but if we're ever going to have Nerf gun wars, the kid who uses a wheelchair is going to be kind of stationary. So we'd definitely like to mount this to a wheelchair. I'll do a follow-up video on that, just in case when I come up with something. But yeah, besides those two problems, I think this actually works really well. 25 shots, there's plenty of darts for a good game and lots of fun and practice. It's pretty inexpensive. Overall, I think this cost me about $75 or $80, which is pretty cheap when you look at Switch accessible toys on the market. Thanks for watching.